you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Hello, Virginia. Did anybody last night watch a thing called a debate? That was a big one. But as you saw on television last night, we had a big victory against a man that really is looking to destroy our country. He's the worst. He's the most corrupt, the most incompetent president in the history of our country. And we have to take it back from that party. That's an evil party, despite the fact that crooked Joe Biden spent the entire week at Camp David resting, working, studying. He studied very hard. He studied so hard that he didn't know what the hell he was doing. He got the debate rules that he wanted. He got the date that he wanted. He got the network that he wanted with the moderates he wanted. No amount of rest or rigging could help him defend his atrocious record. It's not defensible. I don't care who you were. You could be the late, great Clarence Darrow. Has anyone ever heard of Clarence Darrow? He was known as quite a good debater. Not as good as your governor, but that's okay. Hello, governor. I can't miss this guy in the crowd. But his son's much better looking than him. Joe Biden's problem is not his age, it's his competence. He's grossly incompetent. You know, they keep saying old. I know people that are much older than him that are doing unbelievable things, making a fortune. I knew a man that at 79, he was never a success, and he made $1.5 billion from 79 to 92. And that's what it is. It's not his age, it's his competence. He's not respected anywhere in the world. Our country is being laughed at all over the world. Biden is using the weaponization of his Justice Department, the FBI, local district attorneys, and attorneys general to try and win an election against his political opponent. That happens to be me. Do you know who I am? Something that actually was unthinkable in our nation, but which is very common in third world countries or in banana republics. That's what he's doing. He's using law enforcement to try and hurt his political opponent. Every one of those things last night, you saw that, was all started by this guy, this crooked guy. And just so bad in so many ways. He's killing our country. He's incapable of winning based on his far left policies of open borders, massive tax increases, the Green New Scam. That's a windmill on every corner, most of which don't work. And things like putting men in women's sports, really not a great idea. As every American saw firsthand last night, this election is a choice between strength and weakness, competence and incompetence, peace and prosperity, or war or no war. They like a war. They love wars. You know, they love killing people. It's so wonderful. You know, I'm the only president in many, many decades that didn't start a war. I finished one. I beat ISIS in record time. As soon as I left, we had the situation where Russia went into Ukraine. They would have never done that. And where Israel's attacked. And then we had inflation. And then we had that horrible, horrible event that took place in Afghanistan. The worst, I think the most embarrassing moment in the history of our country. And it's a choice, though, between a president who puts America first or a train wreck who puts America last. They put America last. Actually, the Democrats put America last. You take a look at that. Look at a guy like Senator Schumer. I've always known him. I've known him a long time. I come from New York. I knew Schumer. He's become a Palestinian. He's a Palestinian now. Congratulations. He was very loyal to Israel and to Jewish people. He's Jewish, but he's become a Palestinian because they have a couple of more votes or something. Nobody's quite figured it out. A vote for Joe Biden is a vote for failure, surrender, and disaster for our country. A vote for your all-time favorite president, President Donald